Motion to close that session. I need a motion to close that session.
Tell you, man.
Miss 24.
I need a motion to close the session. I gotta wait on Mr. Honeycutt for his meeting.
Yeah, he'll be here in a second.
Close the session. What I'd like to say is that we did meet on personnel matters and we did not take any action. And we did meet with Ms. Horton. And at this point, no action was taken. So we are back into our regular, oh, Tim's not here. I'm sorry. They had to take a break.
Yeah, I think Mr. Honeycutt will be back here in a second too.
You guys just come out of closed session just now?
We did. You didn't miss that.
I did say that we did meet with Ms. Horton on personnel matters and no action was taken. And I'm sorry, we're waiting on Tim Sutton.
And
Craig.
Make the big announcement when they come.
If you're late in church, they start clapping for you at my church when you come in.
They recognize you when you walk
boy,
in the door.
Boy, they do. They tell you, better not be late. And I just bow down.
I see them bug feeding. Oh,
yep,
boy.
They're back.
We started talking. I forgot.
We're waiting on you guys.
I'm sorry.
Yay! Okay, we are back in session. And now we're going to have the commissioner's comments, and I'll start with Eddie.
I don't have any.
Okay, Dan?
Madam Chair, we have a letter from Elon University back in January of 2005. We sent them a letter of support for their endeavor where they received a $1 million grant for purchasing biodiesel transportation there at the university. And they are in the process of applying for another federal transportation grant that would add two additional bio buses and also provide replacements for their current buses that will reach maturity by the end of the grant period. This transportation grant would be composed of 80% federal, 10% state, and 10% private funds. And they have asked us if we would also send another letter of support on their behalf. And I would like to do that. Just ask for a consensus of the board to direct the manager to do so.
Right here.
No, I think just consensus would be fine.
Is everybody in favor of that?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Tim?
Fine.
Okay, I have one thing to say. I want to just clear up something about the all the people that signed the that wanted Kim fired, okay? And when they signed the papers that they, all those names, we had about 1,000. And the comment was that I said they were not significant, okay? And so I asked Dan that night, I said, Dan, what do I do with all these names? I've never had this before. And he said, I don't know. And I said, well, I'm going to give them to the county manager, and Mr. Honeycutt can tell you that's exactly what I did with them. And I said, I don't know what to do with these, and would you handle them? Is that not right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So when...
I remember seeing him briefly, and we had a brief conversation, and I forgot about it, which, so, you know, I had a senior moment.
I just want the people to know that it wasn't that I thought they were not important. It was just I didn't know what to do with them.
Yeah, they were.
And so I did turn them over to the county manager, okay?
And, Madam Chairman, in the future, we'll make sure that the entire board is aware of what was in the packet and what type of petition or,
right,
or
that we did have that petition.
So to make you sure you're fully aware of what was in it.
Okay.
Point of clarification, I understand there's three petitions, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I thought there was the one in regards to the termination, there was only, I thought I was told 300 some names.
And then there was one.
One was 400. I got an email on one of them.
One was dealing with wanting us to set aside the revale.
Revaluation.
One was, you know, for termination, and then the third one was to help us out with the, you know, the tax and look at revenue neutral, I think.
There weren't 1,000 names for termination specifically.
No. I didn't actually count them, and when I. Okay. Yeah, Thomas got a copy of them. So did Mr. Boyer. Is that right? Mr. Boyer, did you have a copy?
And I think my recollection is pretty close.
Okay. Anyway, I didn't want the people to think that. I didn't think they were important. I just didn't have a clue what to do with them. I never had one before. Okay, that done. Are there any announcements?
Hit that thing.
If not, we are adjourned.
Thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners meeting. Meetings of the Commissioners Board occur on the first and third Monday of each month in the Commissioners' Chambers on the second floor of the County Office Building located at 124 West Elm Street in Graham. Changes to the meeting schedule will be posted on the Commissioners' website at www.alamance-nc.com. You can watch the most recent meeting of the Commissioners on the second and fourth Friday of each month on Time Warner's local public access channel beginning at 3 p.m. You can also watch recordings of the most recent meeting and past meetings by going to our website at www.alamance-nc.com. Please visit our website for more information on watching Commissioner meetings online. For technical questions about this meeting's online or television broadcast, please contact our county webmaster at webmaster@alamance-nc.com. Please note that this address is for technical questions only. Questions or comments regarding the content of commissioner meetings may be made to the commissioners themselves. You can find their contact information at the Alamance County website at www.alamance-nc.com. Click on the link that says County Commissioners to visit the Commissioners' website, where you can learn about our Commissioners, read minutes of past meetings, access agendas, and find other information about our Board of Commissioners. You can also send mail correspondence to the County Commissioners by addressing it to the Alamance County Commissioners, 124 West Elm Street, Graham, North Carolina, 27253. Again, thank you for tuning in to the Alamance County Commissioners' meeting.